So the first thing we need to ask ourselves is, who are Microsoft's customers? Well, do you think they're software developers? No, not at all. Software developers are not Microsoft's customers. We don't give Microsoft any money. Frontline guys on the ground don't pay a penny for anything. So do they care about us? Dunno. Companies and enterprises are Microsoft's customers. Your boss is Microsoft's customer. Your employer is Microsoft's customer. They pay Microsoft money. You do not. So what do Microsoft's customers actually want? Look at this guy. What's he thinking? He sadly wants cheaper developers. That is the whole point of all of this, of everything they're doing, everything they've ever done, and everything they will do, is to make their corporate customers happy. So in non-Microsoft development worlds, let's just say the bar is a little bit higher. You need to learn file systems and text editors, documentation, and you actually have to learn stuff like how to deploy your software. In the Microsoft world, you get Visual Studio and IntelliSense and right-click publish. So it's a bit of a forbidden word or phrase these days, but IQ used to or may not still be a thing, and I have to read this disclaimer, that it can be used to perpetuate stereotypes and discrimination. So let's not use IQ in its traditional sense, but I'd like to introduce a term just to explain this concept a little bit easier, and that is developer IQ, or DIQ for short. So let's say you have a 100 DIQ, yeah? And let's say that this is somebody with a 100 DIQ has an average productivity in their chosen development environment. So a Microsoft developer with a 100 DIQ is just your average developer with the Microsoft tools. Let's say below average productivity developer is 80 DIQ. Now your employer needs to pay big bucks for the 100 DIQ developer and a little bit less for the 80 DIQ developer, assuming that productivity meets the market. So for the entirety of the Microsoft development stack DevTools history, Visual Studio from 2003 onwards to the present day has all been about this, making developer tooling, the Microsoft tooling, get 80 developer IQ developers up to 100, get them just about productive. And as a result, Microsoft gets a bit of that value by charging your employer or the companies and the enterprises for that tooling. They pay Visual Studio subscription fees and so on, and pay for Microsoft consulting and everything else. The total costs of that developer ends up being a little bit less than the raw tool-less 100 developer IQ developer. Your employer or the companies or the enterprises save money, and Microsoft makes a little bit of money. Now that's very pessimistic, you might say. Well, if you are one of the above average developers, let's say your baseline of developer IQ is 120, which would be pretty good in comparison here, and you've all met these developers, they're really, really good. Even though with the law of diminishing returns, they still use the Microsoft tooling, but as a result, they get a little bit further and they become slightly more productive. This is good, and there's lots of developers out there who are like this. Now, I don't think that the tooling makes a massive difference if you're already above average. So there is a diminishing return here. So if you're below average, the tooling helps you get further up that value chain. However, if you are already average, you can become slightly above average. So how does this affect you? Well, if you're one of the average developers and you get that little bit of extra oomph with the tooling, you're still not that much better than the below average developer with all of that tooling. The tooling costs the same amount of money, but you are more expensive. So your competition is coming from those below average baseline developers. And therefore, I would call this the danger zone. Now, where is Microsoft going with the AI tooling that's coming through at the moment? Well, my theory is they're not trying to make average developers better, and they're not trying to make your super developers better or even better. They're actually trying to do this. They're trying to bring even lower skilled developers up to that baseline, and they will take even more money. So your Copilot fees and everything else, they'll just charge your employer more. However, your employer will be super happy because they get to spend less overall for the same amount of productivity. Now I know what you're saying. This is just Microsoft stuff, Ted. Yeah? Well, they're coming for everything else as well. It's pretty crazy. Copilot is it's not a product for developers. That's the key thing here. I mean, even this thing I pinched off Google, now available for all businesses. This is not aimed at developers. This is aimed at employers of developers to bring that baseline up and enable them to initially hire less skilled developers who are cheaper, and there are more of them. I mean, look, 55% faster coding, more code written. This is not for your frontline guys. This is for management. So where does this leave everybody? This is my view. This is the summary here. Yeah. So if you're a below average dev, there's going to be more jobs for you because these tools will enable you to work more. But don't think that these are you're going to be paid the lofty heights of the skilled developers from pre-2024. If you are above average, I think you're going to be absolutely fine because the tools will keep you with that edge. You'll know where the AI is wrong and you'll be able to spot mistakes and you'll be better at prompt writing, which is great. But if you are an average developer, this is where it gets a bit dicey, I think, because I don't think average developers are going to be cost of efficient versus the below average developers, ultimately. So if you are an average dev, I would probably get your skills up or probably move into product management or something that requires less development skills because Microsoft is basically coming for your job. That is my view. If you disagree, please leave a comment and I will get back to you. If you disliked this video, please press the like button 3 times. This registers your absolute disgust with it. See you on the next one.